Hello guys, Life Hackster here. Today will be the second installment of my Toucan camera review. And we will check out their wireless outdoor camera this time. I reviewed their video doorbell a while back and will link it down below if you want to check it out. So today we'll do the unboxing, check out the features, set it up and do the installation. We will then check out the video and audio quality, do the usual battery of tests, and see if this outdoor camera from Toucan will be a good choice for your Wi-Fi security camera needs. Let's check out the features. This is a 1080p Full HD, has two-way talk, has 131 degrees adjustable angle. I'm not sure what that means. It might be the field of view of the camera. It has a magnetic mount, wire-free, motion detection, siren alarm, night vision, Wi-Fi, notifications, battery-powered, waterproof or weatherproof IP56 rated. You do need to download the Toucan Smart Home app to set this up. Let's go to their website and see if we can get more details of the camera's features. The Toucan wireless outdoor camera is $80 for a battery-powered camera. It is also being sold at Amazon for only $69.95, so it is pretty affordable for being battery-powered. 131 degrees adjustable live view. It is 1080p Full HD and records at 20 frames per second. It has two-way audio, siren alarm, and emergency call. It has pre-recorded messages. It uses a PIR motion sensor with instant notifications through the app. Magnetic mount, 24 hours recording in the cloud without subscription. They have the Pro subscription if you want to subscribe to their Shield plans. And it is $299 per month per camera for 7 days of look back. Or they have the Elite plan, which is $999 for 90 days of video storage in the cloud. Now, you might think that the free 24-hour cloud storage might be a good choice, but there are some limitations. Like, you cannot customize the event video recording time. The camera or their firmware automatically determines the length of the recording time, which is based on motion. In my testing, ranging from 15 seconds to a minute. You'll not be able to share access to the camera. You cannot save or bookmark the recording. And you can only download up to 5 clips per month. So you have to take that into consideration. Let's open up the box. We have some paperwork and window decals. We have some screws and plastic anchors. We have a 2-foot micro USB charging cable. We have a double-sided mounting tape. We have a magnetic mount. We have the camera itself, which looks and feels pretty well made, especially for an $80 camera. We have the lens, light sensor, and infrared LEDs, and the PIR sensor in the front. On the sides, we have the Toucan branding. On top, we have a rubber flap that has a set marking. And when you open it up, you will see the set button and also a reset hole. On the bottom, we have the speaker holes, a 1/4-20 thread, and another rubber flap that covers the micro USB port to charge the batteries of the camera, which is built in and not removable and not replaceable. So the mount is magnetic and the back of the camera has a metal plate on it which makes it stick to the mount and secures the camera pretty good and you can easily adjust the camera. Time to set it up. Download, sign up, and log into the Toucan Smart Home app. Click Add New Device. Choose Wireless Outdoor Camera. Choose or type in a name, which I'll name mine Toucan Outdoor. My Wi-Fi is already saved, and press and hold the set button for 3 seconds, and when the blue light begins to flash, release the set button. Wait until the camera is successfully connected. Click Finish. Update the firmware if needed. Let's check out the live view. Yep, it works. Let's check out the settings in the app. On the main app page, you will see the camera with the most recent snapshot. Click on it and you will go to live view. So this is my first gripe on this camera because it doesn't show the whole view of the camera in this vertical orientation of the phone, which is the usual position when you use our smartphones. You can use your finger though to move around the camera's view. Then we can unmute or mute the camera. Then we have the full screen, which you will need to turn your phone to landscape mode. And you'll also be able to access the controls. Click the mic to start full duplex two-way talk. We have pre-recorded messages, and you have 4 options. I'll let you listen how they sound like later on. Video icon to record the current live view and has a limit of about a minute. And this will be saved directly to your phone's photo album. Then we have the snapshot icon to take the current snapshot and will also be saved to your phone's album. SOS, which will have a quick access to dial 911. Then we have the siren. On the upper right corner is the gear icon to get into the camera settings. First, we have a Do Not Disturb, which is to turn off motion detection and notifications. You can also schedule this if you want. We have the video date and timestamp if you want it shown on the recordings. Then night vision. You can choose automatic, always on, or always off. Motion sensor sensitivity, which the only choices are max, high, medium, and low. There are no motion zoning or people detection. Emergency call, if you want to call someone instead of 911. Power source, which I thought I will unlock other features like motion zones and motion pre-recording when the camera is plugged in, but it doesn't. When you sign up for their monthly subscription, you will get the siren duration option and event video limit, which are only available if you sign up to at least their pro plan. Time to do the installation. And with the notch, just align it on the big hole first and pull down. There you go. And that's actually pretty solid. This is the magnetic base. It's magnetic and has a metal part right here that is magnetized, and you can easily adjust it. Same thing with the Arlo and with the Eufy cameras. Same setup. Now time to do some testing. We'll check out the video and audio quality first. But please note, because of some limitations like the recording length and a major one which I'll tell you after the video quality footage, I have to record the video and audio footage using the live view recording, which is pushing the video camera icon while it is in live view. And this is also why I know there is a 1 minute recording limit, using the live view recording. Normally, in all my other videos, unless I state it, the footage will be from what is recorded when the camera detects motion. And I usually customize the recording length depending on how long I want it to record. Anywho, this is the video and audio quality of the Toucan wireless outdoor camera.
So this is the video and audio quality of the Toucan wireless camera. And this is the video clarity test. So this is the video quality of the Toucan outdoor wireless security Wi-Fi camera, and this is at night with the night vision on, and actually the night vision is set on auto, and this is why it looks like no lights. This is what it looks like when I'm 10 feet, 15, 20, 25. 30. And my shit, the light turned on. So this is the video quality of the Toucan outdoor wireless security camera at night and with the night vision off and all my lights are on. And this is what it looks like at 10 feet, 15, 20, 25, 30.
This is the audio test coming out from the Toucan wireless outdoor security camera.
Hello, who is it? How can I help you? No soliciting, thank you.
So when I was testing the motion alert notification speed, I noticed that the camera is not consistent in detecting me. And I'm not getting any notification. Nothing. I bumped up the sensitivity to max, which worked after several failed tries to detect me. So we are going to test the motion alert notification speed of the Toucan outdoor wireless security camera. And I'm on my LTE connection. The motion sensitivity, I've changed it to the maximum sensitivity, which is, I think, max. That's what it's called. So it's 636 and LTE connection. So let's check it out. I'm also gonna go beyond 10 feet right here because it was not detecting me earlier, less than 10 feet. There you go. I got a notification. And let's open it up. And this is how it opens, how fast it opens up in the app. I have installed this camera in my backyard for more than a week now, but haven't really tested it for this video. But I noticed then that it's not consistent and reliable in motion detection. I didn't really pay attention to it until I was filming for this review. The motion detection is not reliable, and I think and hopefully it is a firmware issue. I even have placed the camera with max sensitivity in my living room and with everybody just moving around, and it only recorded a few times. It will record consistently for a few minutes, then will just stop detecting. I cannot pinpoint what the problem is. I noticed though that the camera also tends to time out when loading live view. Video and audio quality is actually pretty decent, and it records at 20 frames per second. But what's the point of having a good video quality if the camera doesn't detect all motion and is not reliable? So hopefully Toucan can fix this. I've also noticed and Toucan stated that the camera can last 4 months to a year before needing to be recharged. But it really depends on how often it gets triggered. I charged it for a couple of hours last week from being charged at the factory. And I started with 3/4 of battery life. But after a week of testing and recording, which were not a lot recordings because of the unreliable motion detection, I have a red empty battery life when I was recording and showing the settings. So I'm not sure about the battery life of this camera. Anyways, any questions? Comment down below. But before I end this video, I've been testing another new camera, which I can't wait to share with you guys. So it's about 9:10 in the evening. And as you can see, I'm recording using my DJI Osmo Pocket, and it is pretty dark outside. And as you can see, those are the solar lights on my shed. And I'm testing a new IP Wi-Fi PoE camera that has dual lens, and it helps with caller night vision. And I'll show you the caller night footage right now. Exactly the same like how I'm seeing it with my DJI Osmo Pocket, and this is what the camera sees. So for my $25 Amazon e-gift card giveaway, if you know the brand and the model of this camera, comment down below, and the first person to comment the correct answer will get the gift card. One person, one guess, and no multiple guesses and no editing of your comments. So we will check it out and see how it looks like, and I'll show you the footage.
It has a spotlight too, so this is how it will look like. And I go, it has human detection also, and it has a spotlight. And see, if you know the brand and model of this camera, so comment down below. Good luck.
Thanks for watching, and I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to share and give this a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. And click the bell icon so as to get notified when I upload product reviews like this video, product updates, comparison videos, and long-term reviews. Thank you.